Hey guys, it's Jack Jack and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we're doing another Bible journaling video. I'm so stoked. For this video, I am using a Dot Grid Erin Condren hardbound journal. I will have something similar linked below. She still has these Dot Grid journals, but they're softbound, not hardbound. So there's the only difference, but any journal will work, honestly. You just need to grab a journal and bring your creativity and you can do whatever you please. So here are the spreads that we did last time. If you missed my last Bible journaling video where I did these with you guys, I'll leave that linked in the cards for you guys. This Galatians 5, 22-23 one is definitely my favorite. I love it so much. And then we did Genesis 9, 13 over here, and I'm gonna show a few more spreads today. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and jump on into it. So for this one, I am going to be doing Proverbs 16, 9, and I have this little hiker girl that I traced out and then some little mountains and trees. And I decided to just draw it on like just random scrap paper. Oh, scrap paper. I couldn't think of the word scrap for a minute. But yeah, I just have this scrap paper. And I drew these on because I like cutting things out and gluing things into the journal. I like adding like the different textures to my Bible journaling. I just think it's fun. So I'm just taking my pen and tracing out the little drawings that I did, and then I'm going to color them in with my coloring pencils. And I'll be sure to link everything that I'm using in the description box for you guys. So be sure to check that out if you want links to buy anything, any of the supplies that I'm using today. So once I'm done coloring everything in, I'm actually going to rip apart, kind of similar to the previous spread that we did, so that way it has like jagged edges when I glue it down. You can use scissors to make it a clean cut, but I kind of wanted the jagged edged look. So I'm just ripping this off, and then we're going to just glue this down, and then we'll go ahead and write out the verse. So Proverbs 16, 9 says, "In their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps." I really like this verse because as much of a planner as I am, it's important to remember that at the end of the day, it's what God has planned for me, not what I have planned for myself. So I wanted to do this spread or do this verse, and I wanted to do like footsteps, but I thought doing a little hiker girl with the mountains would have like look cuter. So that's what I ended up doing. Here's my little path, which my goodness is really, really ugly looking. But now I'm just going to take a mild liner and write out the verse. Again, in their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps. Proverbs 16, 9. And this is kind of an unnecessary step, but I'm taking my pen and I'm outlining all of the letters just to make it look a little more bold. I just think like little details like this kind of enhance your Bible journaling spreads. If you guys are into Bible journaling, I would love to see you guys Bible journal the same verse as me, so that way I can see your creative spin on the verse. So our spreads don't have to look the same, obviously. This is just what I wanted to do, and these videos are just to, you know, give you some inspiration and encourage you to have a little fun and be a little creative when memorizing Bible verses. So, oh look, I ended up doing little footsteps. So that's what this spread looks like. Again, I just want these to help inspire you and maybe encourage you to use your creativity. So moving on to the next one, we're going to do Psalm 23, verse 2-3. And for this, I want to use these really pretty floral stickers from the Happy Illusion sticker book. Oops, Zoe just went down the stairs if you guys heard that. I'm gonna use those stickers, but first I'm going to take some washi tape, and I got this washi from Daiso, and it came in a pack with like a bunch of like neutral tone colors, which I was obsessed with. But I wanna take this pink one because it matches the flowers, and I'm creating a box, and basically we're gonna write the verse in the box, and then the florals are gonna be all around it, kind of like coming out. Wow, Zoe. Sorry about that, she saw a dog. So I'm going to go ahead and grab these stickers, and I'm going to randomly place them all around this box. And I shared this in a vlog, and I think a Plan With Me video, but just slice, take an X-Acto knife and slice the sticker if it goes on top of the washi tape. So that way it has like a clean edge and it looks like the flowers are actually sticking out from behind the washi tape box that we created. It just looks really cool. So I'm just doing that all throughout until the whole page is full of these florals. So now we're gonna take our pen and just go ahead and write out the verse. I'm actually doing verses 1, 2, and 3 from Psalm 23. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake." And since I forgot to leave room to actually write the verse, I'm just taking more scrap paper and writing the verse on here. I put Psalm 23, verse 2 and 3, but again, like I mentioned, it's actually verse 1 through 3. So I'm just going to cut that into a little rectangle and then with some glue, just glue it down right there at the bottom. And I actually really like how this looks. Now I'm going to take my eraser and erase all of the traces that I did with my pencil. And then I'm going to go in and with all of the cursive words, because I don't know if you guys noticed, I did like regular letters and then cursive letters, regular letters, like I kind of alternated. And with the cursive letters, I'm just going to make them a little bold. And I've mentioned how I do this like faux calligraphy thing in my hand lettering video. So I'll leave that linked in the cards for you guys. I mean, my handwriting's messy. Look at this. This is not the best, but if you do want to learn how I do my lettering, I'll leave that video linked in the cards. But I'm sure there's better ones on YouTube. I do not have the best handwriting. So that's it for that spread. So moving on to the next one, I'm gonna be doing John 12:13. And for that, I wanted to use these like palm leaves and palm trees. It's gonna be so perfect. So I'm gonna start by taking these two palm trees. This is from the same Happy Illustration sticker book from Me and My Big Ideas or the Happy Planner. So I will leave that linked in the cards if you, or not in the cards, in the description box if you want to pick up this same sticker book. But I'm putting the palm trees at the top and bottom, and that's kind of like the main decoration for this page, and then we'll go ahead and write the verse. So with my X-Acto knife, I'm just going to slice the little edge over here because it kind of went over on the previous page, so just cleaning that up. And now in this verse, there's quotes, so I want to do three separate little quote bubbles. I think this is gonna look so cute. And again, I'm drawing it on scrap paper. Again, I like adding different elements to my Bible journaling by cutting things out and gluing them in. And so I'm just tracing that over with black so it kind of sticks out better and cutting those out. And then I'm going to glue them in and I'm writing in the quotes right now. So one of them says, "Hosanna." The next one says, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." And then the last one says, "Blessed is the King of Israel." So now I'm going to glue those down and make sure I glue them in order. And then I'm going to go ahead and write the rest of this verse. So in like full, this verse, John 12:13 says, "They took palm branches and went out to meet him, shouting, 'Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel.'" So that's why I thought the palm trees would just go so perfectly with this spread. And so once I finish out writing the rest of the verse, I'll go ahead and go back to my sticker book and grab some more stickers to decorate in like the gaps and spaces. And then finally with the spread, I'm just going to take a green Erin Condren marker and fill in the letters, like how it has that like space right there when I was writing it out. So I'm just filling it in, and that completes this spread, and I love it. You know I have a thing for palm trees, so I love how this one turned out, and even the little quotes, I think they're so cute. So moving on to the last one we're gonna do today, I have these cute little skeletons that I traced out. They're so stinking cute, I can't even get over it. Like, they're adorable, and they're like dancing. So the verse that I'm using, it's from Ezekiel, it's chapter 37, verse 4, and it's talking about like the dry bones, like the dry bones awakening. And so that's why I thought it'd be so cute to do little skeletons, and they're dancing, like they're coming to life. So that's what we're doing, and that's really the only decorative element to this particular spread. I wanted to keep it fairly simple, so I just have these little skeleton guys. If you don't know how to draw skeletons, you can look on Google and just like trace it out, or just cut out pictures. If you can find like a magazine with little skeletons in it, you can put that in there. And I'm not even doing anything fancy with the lettering either. I'm just keeping this one very simple. But Ezekiel chapter 37 verse 4 says, "Then he said to me, 'Prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you and you will come to life.'" That's actually verse 4 and 5. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and finish that up. But that completes this spread, and I love it. These skeletons are so cute. I can't get over them. They're the cutest thing ever. Man, there are like a million planes flying over my apartment today. But anyways, hope that wasn't too distracting. But that is it for this Bible journaling video. I'm saying it so much. I can't get over the skeletons. They're so cute. So here is a look through of all the spreads we did today. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you want to see more Bible journaling videos, let me know in the comments what verse you'd like me to do. I think that'd be fun. And if you recreate any of these verses, whether it's completely different or inspired by the spread that I did, I would love to see. So please tag me in your photos on Instagram and send them over, because it would make me so happy to see. So let me know which spread was your favorite in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!